Calendar number 1842 by Senator Martin, Senate Print 8017, Act Amend the Education Law.
Last section.
Section 4, this act should take effect immediately.
Call roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Senator Kaminsky to explain his vote.
Mr. President, I rise to explain my vote in the affirmative and to really thank Senator Martin for putting forward this legislation. Throughout our college campuses, something toxic, quite cancerous is happening, where we have students coming into college as one person and leaving with anti-Israel and, frankly, anti-Semitic views. I'd like to just tell a brief story. I was lucky enough to go with the Assembly delegation to Israel last December, and we met a Palestinian journalist who has what would be considered kind of left-wing, moderate, almost pro-Israeli views in Palestine. And he said that he will go all over the Palestinian territories, all over Israel to talk about his views, but he will never again go to the University of Michigan and to Marquette University and the University of Wisconsin because he was spat on. It's gotten to a point where students are intimidated and people are using what they consider on its face to be a political movement as a way to hold anti-Semitic views and intimidate other students. Congresswoman Nita Lowey just was the author of a letter signed by many congresspersons that cited statistics that over 500 anti-Israel programs on U.S. college campuses as of 2015, an increase of 38% over the prior year, and that 29 BDS movement campaigns sponsored from student groups exist, an increase of 21% from the prior year. And according to the FBI Hate Crime Statistics Act report, the number of incidents, offenses, and victims of anti-Jewish bias make up a majority of all hate crimes motivated by religious bias, even though they've decreased countrywide since 2010. Something is going wrong on our college campuses. It's time we stand up for students so that they could hold their views and we could have legitimate discussions on issues. But when it comes to anti-Semitism, when it comes to intimidation, we must take a stand. That's what this bill does. I thank Senator Martin for this bill. I vote in the affirmative.
Senator Kaminsky, to be recorded in the affirmative, would you please, those in the negative, raise your hand again, and Senator Krueger to explain her vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. I rise to explain my vote no on this bill tonight. I'm also a proud Jew, a Zionist, brought up in a Zionist family, who's very concerned about anti-Semitism and hate speech of any kind. But you know what this country has taught me, and it should have taught us all, that it is better to allow those who preach ideology we fundamentally oppose to express their positions in rhetoric, rather than be panicked into embarking on the dangerous course of permitting the government to decide what its citizens may say or hear. The ability of American society to tolerate the advocacy of even hateful doctrines, is perhaps the most important protection we have in our democracy. That was written by a judge deciding the case of the right of the Nazis to march in Skokie in the mid-70s. He was right then. We must protect our freedom of speech. People say and do stupid things, but when we allow the government to determine that they can't say them, we walk down a very dangerous road for this country. We can address these issues without passing a law like this. I vote no, Mr. President.
Krueger to be recording the negative. Senator Martins to explain his vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. I rise to support this bill and to vote aye. What this bill does is it prevents taxpayer money from being used to foster groups that would harass students on campuses. Whether it's anti-Semitic speech, whether it's hate speech on the basis of religion or race or gender or sexual orientation, this bill would prevent taxpayer money from being used on campuses to support groups that decide to organize and to spew hate. Now, I agree with some of the sentiments that have been stated here. Everyone has an absolute right to free speech. We protect it each and every day. That's why that is one of the critical points of our democracy, that we do have the ability to defend other people's rights to express themselves. But we don't have to pay for it, Mr. President. Our taxpayers do not have to pay for hate speech on campuses. We don't have to pay for people to be spat upon, to be ridiculed, to be harassed on our institutions of higher education. And whether it's based on race, whether it's based on ethnic background, whether it's based on gender or sexual orientation, or whether it's based on religion, there is no place in higher education for hate, and certainly no place for our taxpayers to be funding hate on campuses. So that's what this bill would do. It would prevent our tax money to going to institutions of higher learning to promote these organizations that are organized on campuses and to basically legitimize them. It's wrong. It's wrong regardless of whether it's anti-Semitism. It's wrong whether it's people who are anti-black, anti-Jew, anti-Catholic, anti-whatever. You fill in the blank. So this is an opportunity for this chamber to make a statement. It's also an opportunity for everybody who voted no to rethink their vote and to vote yes. People can say whatever they want. Our taxpayers and our tax dollars shouldn't fund it. Mr. President, I vote aye.
Senator Martin will be recording the affirmative. Announce the results.